Eat rice, reverse diabetes. Isn't it a radical statement? How can somebody eat rice and treat diabetes? Yes, it is possible. At Ayurveda Ayurveda, me along with my team, we are giving rice to our patients and we are very well handling diabetes and we are having many success stories. About diabetes, if you search in the internet, you have videos, you have articles, you have research papers, what not. Everything about diabetes is available in the internet today. So let's not go into what diabetes is, but let's concentrate how easily diabetes can be treated with the help of rice. For treatment of diabetes, it is very important that you know the concept of glycemic index. If you understand glycemic index, you can treat diabetes very easily. What is glycemic index? The rate at which the glucose is getting mixed into the blood is called as glycemic index. Any food you take can be either a high glycemic index food or a low glycemic index food or a moderately glycemic index food. When you have high glycemic index food, the insulin also correspondingly increases along with the high glycemic index food. When you have low glycemic index food, the insulin also will release slowly. Insulin is a hormone produced by the pancreas. If a high glycemic food is ingested, instantly there is a pressure on the pancreas and the pancreas will suffocate before it produces the insulin necessary to take out the excess glucose produced as a result of a high glycemic index food. If you take high glycemic index food and low glycemic index food, people have confusion which are all high glycemic index and which are all low glycemic index. I'll give you a few examples. The white rice, wheat, maida, bread and many other such kind of food, like all sweets are high glycemic index. A tablespoon of sugar is having a high glycemic index. Cool drink is having a very high glycemic index. When you come to low glycemic index, the best example is the traditional rice. Most people don't know what traditional rice is. I take this opportunity to introduce traditional rice to you all. Across India, there were lakhs and lakhs of traditional rice varieties available. But as a result of this green revolution, gradually we lost touch with the traditional rice varieties and modern rice varieties came into picture. Most of the modern rice varieties available in the market is having a very high glycemic index and which are creating more and more diabetics in the society. Ponni rice, Sona Masuri rice, Matta rice are the basic rice varieties consumed in South India, and all the rice varieties have a very high glycemic index and they are very harmful for the body. When a high glycemic index food is consumed, they convert into glucose and the glucose is instantly released into the blood. The higher the amount of glucose, the higher the demand for the insulin. The higher the demand for the insulin, the more the pancreas undergoes pressure. When the pancreas is undergoing pressure, slowly the cells in the pancreas will start dying, and that is when the diabetes sets in. For a better understanding, let's see the example of a toll booth. Imagine from 12 a.m. to 6 p.m., 100 cars are coming and passing through the toll booth. The toll booth operator handles that comfortably and he is fine with it. If the same 100 cars are coming within a gap of 15 minutes, just imagine the condition of the toll booth operator. He is put a lot of pressure, right? So simple it is. The same thing happens to the pancreas also. The carbohydrate or the glucose is not very important. The rate at which the carbohydrate is getting mixed into the blood, the rate, that is the most important. If we manage to increase the rate of glucose mixing into the blood, the diabetic is helped in a big way. What happens if you consume traditional rice? Since the traditional, most of the traditional rice varieties have low glycemic index, it takes a lot of time for digestion and the blood glucose is released slowly, and the pancreas has a lot of time to deal with the rate of glucose coming inside, and the person is hale and healthy. Also, by consuming traditional rice varieties, The person can never get diabetes in his life because the pancreas gets all the time in the world to manage the glucose. So this traditional rice variety is given with lots of ghee. Ghee is again fat. Fat again postpones the time for digestion. And the glycemic index of the meal is reducing at a big way. So having lots of ghee to the traditional rice with lots of vegetables, fiber again slows down the digestion, decreases the glycemic index. So basically what I'm trying to tell you is the Indian traditional meal had a very low glycemic index and most of the people were not diabetics those days. In Ayurveda, people who got diabetes are given this traditional meal with traditional rice with good amount of ghee and vegetables, and we are getting great results, and I wanted to share this with you all so that these traditional rice varieties will be used by you all and the farmers who are growing these traditional rice varieties will be supported. For you to Google, I'll list out a few traditional rice varieties which are helpful for diabetes. There are many other rice varieties which are good for other health conditions, but since today we are talking about diabetes, I would like to list a few traditional rice varieties which help in reversing the diabetes. Maapile Sambar seems to be very effective in treating diabetes. Of course, there are other traditional rice varieties which are having very low glycemic index, like Karupu Kauni, Kaatiyanam, Val Sevappu, Nyavara, and many other rice varieties. So this is all about diabetes and rice. You can go ahead and have rice and still be a non-diabetic. So what are you waiting for? Order traditional rice varieties, switch your rice, change your life for good. Thank you.